When the market has a much bigger demand than supply, clients often ask, should I go no subject? Let's find out. Let's do this. How's it going? My name is John and I am a mortgage broker located in Vancouver, and welcome to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn ways to be approved for a mortgage, home buying tips, and other mortgage related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking on the notification bell so you won't miss anything. Let's start off with what exactly does no subject mean. It means that you're making an offer to buy a property without any conditions. Generally, conditions may include terms such as subject to financing and inspection. So, should you go no subject? As a mortgage broker, I can never recommend you to go no subject to financing. Why? Because in the event the mortgage can't get approved, I'm in huge problems. Do you have to put a no subject to financing? Actually, you don't. It's not a requirement from the banks or lenders. It's simply a term to allow you to back out of the purchase in the event that you cannot obtain financing. But before you choose to go ahead to not put that term in order to make your offer more attractive to the seller, you need to know the risks. Some may say, well, I'm pre-approved already, so I can go no subject, right? Well, not really. The pre-approval is based only on your income and credit score. Another big piece of the puzzle for a mortgage is the actual property. The bank must want to secure the property in order to proceed with the mortgage. There are times when they may not. For example, the property may be a previous marijuana grow up, or it may not be in livable condition, or if it's a condo and there's a huge repair that's been passed by strata, or there's an ongoing project. Or what if the price you've offered is way higher than the actual appraised value? These are the most common reasons why a lender may not want to secure the property. So, as much as I want to give you the go-ahead to go no subject, I can't. It's because I don't have the appraisal yet. So, as a buyer, you'll need to see if you're willing to take on the risk. The pre-approval can only go up to 99% chance of approval, but that 1% is based on what the appraisal report will show. It's never a good idea to go no subject, but I also understand that in a highly competitive market, you gotta do what you gotta do. Just know the risk, see if it's manageable, and have a contingency plan in place in the event the mortgage doesn't get approved for whatever reason. And there you go. We just explained whether or not you should go no subject when you're buying your new home. And please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more. Make sure you click on the notification bell so you won't miss a video. I'm John Lee, mortgage broker and CEO of Rise Mortgage. We're always achieving your approval.